So here we are back because we couldn't stop talking, Isabella and I.
I always get so inspired.
Yes. So, but yeah, I don't know how long the session could be because we both we could talk here for hours.
Yes, I was just saying to Sabina, all of a sudden I think of when it comes to comparing Kundalini and the energy and the consciousness and the awareness that you eventually bring together and in your own practice is like a professional athlete. You know, they spend all their time training hard and focusing, and when it comes to the day of that where they have to put it all together, they use their breath, their mind, and the energy from everything else, because like you said before, we're all connected, our energy is all connected, and it's kind of, yeah, so Kundalini, the comparable to it is what an athlete brings together. And that's what Kundalini does. It allows you through your practice to totally focus and bring everything together, your breath, your energy, your mind. You teach your mind to be so focused. Mm-hmm.
And whatever you have to perform as an athlete, if you are a runner or whatever sports you are doing, and what we did also in class today, when we did the pranic car and where we powered it out and pushed our arms down. And you know what? In our best times, we do this for 11 minutes. This is long, 11 minutes pumping these. And right there, it's like really an athlete. You have to give your 100%. You have to perform.
Yeah. And when you focus, mm-hmm. and you're going, oh, this is so painful. But you know, really, if you just concentrate on your breath, mm-hmm. and put it all together, you soon forget that.
Yes.
You do. You just focus on your breathing and the power of your breath. Mm-hmm. And for an athlete too, the power of the breath is so important, and the focus, mm-hmm. you know, because in a way they're meditating, right? Mm-hmm. They're so focused on.
Exactly. And what happens, especially runners, what do they get? This runner's high, when they are just so in the zone and they just run and they, everything else around you completely fades away.
Oh, and yeah. You don't even think about that you're running. Because, I mean, I used to run, right? A long time ago. You don't. You just hit that wall. And then once you get past that wall and you get the runner's high, you don't even realize you're running anymore.
Exactly.
You're just your breath. You're connected to your breath and you're just running. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's exactly it. And this is what we actually want to achieve in our yoga class, to get a yoga high.
And it's euphoric. It's absolutely euphoric.
Mm-hmm. And this is what you mentioned, exactly what you mentioned then in earlier in the beginning, when you said after yoga class, I drove home and I had this feeling of happiness and this euphoric feeling in me. Yes. So yes, this is it, that we carry it then home and cultivate it in our day-to-day life. And of course it fades away after a while, but this is why the next day we hit the yoga mat again and do it again.
Exactly. And I think it would be so beneficial for people who are suffering right now from COVID, and you know, that sadness and need to be to connect to that. Right. And it would be such an amazing thing for them.
Yeah.
The yoga mat with Kundalini.
Yes. And in the comfort of our homes, that's the good thing as well. Right now, we really start to love Zoom and the possibility to be connected and have these talks and then also practice together. So Yes. So we give it another try to close for today. But this will be continued. So yes, I'm so happy that more people will join us in the future. I have the feeling more people will. So I just
absolutely
feel it coming.
Yes.
So Isabella, I wish you a lovely weekend, and then I look forward to see you next Monday again in class.
You bet, Sabina.
Bye. Lots of love.
Bye. Bye.